Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. May I welcome you to this WEW Spring Seminar, which the Austrian Central Bank is glad and happy to host the fourth time. So it becomes a tradition that the WEW Spring Seminar takes place at the Austrian Central Bank. And I think it's not really a surprise as the WEW and the Austrian Central Bank, the economists, have a very special focus on this region. So this is our region to analyze a little bit more deeper. And therefore, we have once in a while, and in the meantime quite often, a cooperation on several products and also in events. And I may remind you to the workshop on the Ukraine, which we were happy to make together and organize together a few weeks ago. We have not such a crowd like today, but it was also a remarkable audience, and I think also the program of today is really worthwhile for coming and joining the discussions. As a short introduction, allow me to focus a little bit on the region from the Austrian Central Bank's point of view. And I want to start with this quite positive economic development which characterizes the region. Good for the region, good for us, good for Austria. And I want shortly to present the forecast of the Austrian Central Bank on the region, which is not so much well known, but as it is more or less a background information also for the ECB, for the euro system, for their forecast for the euro area. So we produce the forecast on the Central and Eastern European countries, and this is part of this forecasting process of the euro area. But we do or put this expertise on the region into this process, so far, it's not public yet. It will be discussed in Frankfurt only next week. But still, I will present the first results to you. Along the line of other forecasts on the region, also our economists are quite optimistic for the region. And we think that this quite positive growth rate, especially when you compare it with most euro area countries, will keep on going. And when we have a look to the next few years, it will stay approximately at 3% per year real GDP growth rate. Of course, there is a difference over the countries, as always, but the differences are not huge. And most of the countries will see quite a positive development, improving the economic situation in their countries. What drives these growth rates? Growth will rest on domestic demand, in particular on private consumption, while investment activity will drop in 2016, but regain afterwards. What drives this growth in particular? This investment activity, and this was a surprise for us and also for others. This investment activity is connected to European Union fund utilization, and this was much more intensive than we have thought before, and this is still ongoing. The second major growth driver is export growth. This will weaken a little bit this year, but will strengthen gradually again in line with the soft recovery in euro area of euro area growth rates. Well known, the Austria, the story looks quite different for Russia. So we have seen a deep drop, a deep recession last year, minus 3.7%. And all the quite the forecasts a few months ago, which have been much more optimistic for this year. This is gone, this optimism. Russia will see also this year a deep recession, approximately minus 3% is in our forecast. I have mentioned already export growth, which means export growth is, of course, driven mainly by the euro area for this region still. And this brings me to the not so bright forecast for the euro area, which is represented by this graph. The business climate indicators in the euro area, this is quite dampened. Only a very slight growth rates in this respect. Unfortunately, more or less all sentiment indicators go into the same direction, which is in best case in parallel and not very promising situation in this respect. And this is, of course, also the background of the most recent monetary policy actions of the euro system, which have intensified the quantitative easing. Last but not least, let me go to the euro survey, which is a special product of the Austrian Central Bank. And here you see the first question, so it's a survey. We ask regularly private households in many, many countries of the region questions about their financial behavior, about savings, about taking a loan, what they think about the economic situation of their country, but also of other countries. And to gain more information about the region. And here you can see the answer on the question, what do you think about the economic situation in your country? Will it improve, yes or no? And here, in contradiction to what we have seen before to the euro area sentiment indicators, here you can see what optimism is. So these people definitely think their region will continue to grow, and even more their economies will do much better in the future. Of course, growth is driven by investment, by taking out the credit, and therefore we also have quite specialized questions focusing on the plans of the people in this respect. And here you can see what the answers have been to the question, do you plan to take out a loan? Let me start in 2008. So here you see a very high percentage rate of the answers, 10%, 12%, 15% of the people planned to take out a loan, which may have been a little bit too much as we today we are confronted also with high ratios of non-performing loans. But still, what's important is 2015, so much less plans to take out a loan, much lower plans to take out a loan. The people reacted, became more realistic. Many of them also, one have to say, became unemployed due to the crisis situation. So these plans have been reduced. And I want to focus on one special issue on this graph, which is local currency and foreign currency. You know that the region, quite typical for the region is that the people have a big amount of their loans in foreign currency. Very often the euro, but sometimes the Swiss franc, sometimes even the US dollar, because of several reasons. I do not want to go into this issue, but I want to show you that foreign currency loans, to take out a foreign currency loan, is still an issue for many, many people, surprisingly many people, because these blue bars, they still exist in 2015. And this makes us a little bit worrying, as also the Austrian Central Bank is heavily against these kind of financing for private households where they have no possibility to hedge or have income in this foreign currency. And last slide to this topic. People know exactly what's going on in politics, what's going on on the legal situation, and they follow the promises of the governments to bail them out. So here you can see that it's not so unrealistic for them that it's a bad contract. Quite on the contrary, they think that their government will help them when they come into troubles with this FX credit. So this was it from my side. This was food for thought, I would say so. On the website of the Austrian Central Bank, you will find much more information on these issues, also on the Euro survey. But now it's time to hand over to those who will run the whole day, those the organizers of the WEW Spring Seminar. And let me take the opportunity to congratulate Robert Sterer, so the designated scientific director, to his new position. And I'm very much looking forward to work together with you and to continue our cooperation. Robert, the floor is yours. Mm-hmm.